I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Hey everybody, how you doing? With the ingredients you see in front of you right here, you can make your very own laundry detergent. You can make your own laundry detergent at a minimal cost, won't cost a whole lot, save you some monies, and you have control over the ingredients you put in your actual laundry detergent. If this video sounds slightly familiar, if you've seen my other video where I've actually gone through and made my own laundry detergent, it is very, very similar. As a matter of fact, the ingredients are all the same, with the exception of the soap that you actually add to it. But anyway, I meant to make this video a long time ago, but, you know, life's busy, got stuff to do, and I just didn't do it. But it happens. That's okay. I was out in my garage, and I'm supposed to be cleaning it because it really needs it, but then I became aware that we are running a little low on laundry detergent, so I decided to go ahead and make some more, make this little video. And just so you know, I'm in my garage right now, set everything up real quick so I can make a video. It is 103 degrees at 50% humidity. It's very hot. So if you hear buzzing in the background, that is the fan in the window that's doing a really good job of blowing hot air all over me. But I figured, you know, why not? Suffer for the cause, if you will. And the cause is saving money. Because we need to. I need to. Saving money is great. Because then I get to keep more of it. And then I get to do other stuff like buy food and stuff. Anyway, so like I said before, the ingredients you see in front of you, all you need to make your very own laundry detergent. And I have made a recipe list for you, and got it upside down, but it kind of goes like this. Let me see if I can get it right here so you can see it. Here's all you need for your laundry detergent. You need 2 cups of soap. That's where these come in here. We'll talk a little about these soaps that you have right here and what's available to you. 1 cup of borax, 1 cup of washing powder. It's actually super washing soda, but I want to make sure there was a distinction between baking soda and washing powder, or excuse me, super washing soda, because there is a difference. And, you know, one does not substitute for the other, much like with the dishwashing detergent. So, 1 cup borax, 1 cup super washing soda, what I'm going to call washing powder, 1/4 cup of baking soda, and by the time you're done, you only need 1 to 2 tablespoons per load. That is it, 1 to 2 tablespoons per load. If I can figure out where my hands are, I can keep it straight. There you go. Copy this down if you'd like. This is my recipe. There are many recipes like it on the internet because everybody seems to be doing this these days. Mine is slightly different. Yours may vary as well. It's kind of up to you and how you want your soap to be. So you'll have to test it and figure out what works for you. This works for me. I've been using it for about 5 years. It's fantastic. I have saved a ton of money doing this. I know I have, because the entire ingredients you see in front of you run about between 10 and 15 bucks. And if you do the whole thing and put it all in a nice little container, it can last you doing 1 to 2 loads a week for about a year. And if you've got a family of 4, you're going to be doing more loads than I do. But still, you're only looking at 1 to 2 tablespoons per load. It's not bad. Okay, let's do it. Here's the deal with the soap. We'll do that first. A couple different types of soap out there. I like the Zote soap. Smells good. Comes in a nice little wrapper. It says, for a delicate wash. You might have a hard time finding this. It seems like it's been kind of hard to find here recently. But what I found is if you have a Mexican market, like a Mexican superstore or superstore grocery store, they typically carry it. It is a laundry bar, so they have it. It's pretty inexpensive. This, I paid $1.49 for it. I actually bought 5 more bars at the Mexican supermarket. And it didn't really cost us much, but I like it. It smells good. Seems to do very well. It has a little bit of a fragrance to it, but it's not too overpowering or anything like that. It kind of has some kind of a citrusy type smell to it, but it doesn't smell like a bug candle or anything like that. It's pink, which, all right. Yeah, if you like pink, that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. Kind of reminds me of bubble gum. And it smells good. Smells it. Anyway, that's the Zote. You can find Octagon soap at most drugstores and some supermarkets. I think we actually picked this up for, well, we got it for 75 cents, but a lot of grocery stores actually sell it. Food Line is where we used to buy it. It's a little bit different. It kind of has more of a different look to it, actually. It looks more kind of industrial or something as far as soaps go. It's kind of green, really hard, really dense. And it has a different kind of smell. slightly more perfume than this. This has more citrus, this has more of a perfume kind of smell. But I will say that the smells that you have in these bars, they don't overpower your load, they don't smell bad, and it's something that is not a real heavy fragrance, because if you think about the heavy fragrance you have in laundry, it's basically left in your laundry. So you wash your clothes, it smells good, you put the clothes on, you still have soap and the fragrance left over in the clothes. If you got sensitive skin, that kind of, you know, aggravates or exacerbates the problem you have there. So, all right, you got those two. This one is pretty popular. This is the Fels Naphtha. And it says ideal for pre-treating stains. But it's also a laundry bar. So you can actually use it as the soap in your laundry detergent. And it has more of the kind of yellowy look to it. Looks more citrus than anything. It smells pretty good. It actually smells kind of like the Octagon, but I think it's got a little bit more floral in it, if that's your thing. So, not bad. Still hard, dense, works very well. This thing says 100 years of quality. Very nice. So, I like the Zote. That's what I use. Zote also comes with a white bar. The white bar is for even more delicate stuff. So, now here's the deal. If you can't find any of these, like the Zote, the Octagon, the Fels Naphtha, then you can do this. You can actually use good old Ivory right there. So pure, it floats. And the good thing about using Ivory is that it is a light smell to it. It floats, it's slightly softer than the other soaps. It doesn't really have much fragrance, and it definitely doesn't have a whole lot of oils in it. If you're going to use a regular bar soap, which you can do to make your laundry soap, make sure it has no moisturizer in it. If it's got moisturizer in it, that oil or that moisturizing compound that's in that soap will get in your laundry, which gets in your clothes and stays in your clothes until you rinse it out. And if you're washing up the same thing over and over again, you're never really going to rinse it all the way out. So I like Ivory. Ivory has no moisturizer in it, or it has enough moisturizer in it to where it's very, very, very light. And it has, a pretty good smell to it. And you can find these everywhere, and they're pretty cheap. And I like when they say 99.44, pure, clean, and simple. And that's true, and it's good for your laundry. And the reason why it floats, just in case you're curious, is because during the mixing process, they let it mix too long, and they put more air in it. And with the air, it actually made it float. So, there you go. There's your soap. Now we know about the borax, we know about washing powder and baking soda. We actually have a little container to be able to put the soap in. So next you have to figure out how much soap and how to get all the ingredients together, how to mix them up, and I'll show you how to do that in just a second. All right, and we're back. I had to go get a drink because it's still pretty hot in here. It is, I don't know if you can see this or not. Oh, 107 degrees in garage, 47% humidity. Very hot, 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 hot. Anyway, like any good project, that's gonna save you some money. You probably need some tools, and the tools you need are a cheese grater or a grater of some sort, a measuring cup, and all these look pretty dusty and dirty. They're not. They're actually what I use to make laundry soap with, so they're all covered in soap. A large container like a bowl, flowers or not, it's up to you. And then over here off in the distance is a food processor. I bought this old food processor a long time ago, about 6 years ago, from a thrift store for like $4, because I knew that I was going to be chopping up soap and mixing soap. So I decided I would buy one specifically for that purpose. If you have a food processor at home, I don't recommend mixing all this in it and then trying to chop up your salad or something like that, because, well, you might not ever be able to get it clean enough. So if you have one that you use for food, keep it separate from this. Buy one from a thrift store, plug it in, make sure it works. Buy one for cheap and use that to make your laundry soap, because it needs to be mixed. When you mix it all up, it's really easy to use one of these guys. You know, hit the button, and it actually mixes up pretty good. Anyway, talk about that in just a second. Okay, so we've got our tools. And effectively, since we had the recipe last time, it's a little bit slightly different than before. But it's pretty much 2 cups of soap to 1 cup of everything else, with the exception of baking soda, which is 1/4 cup. So, 2, 1, 1/4. So we need to make 2 cups of soap. And then we can add 1 cup of the other two, and then 1/4 cup of baking soda. So pretty much easiest way to do it is you take your soap, open it up, get the grater the way you want it, and get busy. And just keep on going. You're gonna grate. Whoa, knocking stuff all over the place. Probably making a ton of noise too. I don't even know if you can hear me. So I'm not going to go through and make the whole thing. It would take too long. But just kind of give you an idea what we're dealing with here. So pretty much you take your soap, you're actually gonna grate out 2 cups. I'll set that aside. And kinda here's what we got. I don't know if you can see that or not. I don't know. Ooh. You want 2 cups of this. Finely grated, nice and soft soap. Yep, check it. Smells good too. I will say this, if you've got somebody who is in your family who's got asthma or something like that, I don't know if you really want to grate all this and mix all this stuff inside the house. You might want to do it outside because it is powdery. And since we don't actually add a little ingredient to keep it from flying away, because they actually add emulsifiers and things like that to keep it all bunched together so that when you put a scoop in there, you don't have any flyaway, which is a little dust floating in the air. It's another ingredient that they add to your laundry detergent. Since we don't have that, you might want to do it outside or do it somewhere, you know, away from somebody. I'm doing mine in the garage because that's easier. So you want 2 cups of soap. And normally what I do is I grate it. I don't necessarily grate the whole thing. I only grate what I need and save the rest for later. These bars dry out a little bit over time, as do all of these, but that's okay because you can still use it. So grate it out. Get your 2 cups. And I think I'll come back when I've got 2 cups. Be right back. Okay, so I've got the laundry soap, the borax, the super washing soda, aka super washing powder, the baking soda, all loaded in my thrift store food processor. So all I have to do at this point is mix. So let's do that. Ready? Here we go. Give a little bump. Bumpity bump. All we're doing is just mixing up so it's uniform. So we want a nice uniform mix, not a big deal. Plus it does chop up some of the larger parts of the pink soap to make it more uniform. And I think it actually helps it when it dissolves in the washing machine. So just mix it for a little bit.
I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter.